Hello, and welcome to the Center for Spiritual Living Sarasota. We're here to support you in finding a personal relationship with the God of your understanding and discovering what you already know. My name is Catherine Frankert, and I'm a licensed spiritual practitioner here at the Center. And I greet you today with Namaste. Namaste is the Sanskrit word that means the divinity in me recognizes and honors the divinity in you. Let's begin by joining our voices to read aloud our vision and mission. The words can now be seen on your screen. Our vision is empowering spiritual growth. It's a loving, inclusive worldwide community. And this is our mission. We do this by teaching science of mind principles and other life-affirming spiritual truths. We explore, we learn, we grow, we connect, honoring all paths to God. We offer in-person and online weekly services, classes, workshops, affirmative prayer support, and other spiritual tools. We create opportunities for joyful social connection, community outreach, and service. We celebrate the awakening of our innate spiritual magnificence. So now as we prepare for our time of prayer and meditation, I invite you to settle in, connect with the breath. Close your eyes or soften your focus as we turn within. Invite this meditative music to calm your mind and open your heart as Bob Teesdale and our guest soloist, Kassie Coykendall, perform a song by Bob entitled, When I Come to the Spirit. Now in spirit, I remember that there is one power and one presence in life. That life is perfect, whole, and complete. And that life is my life now. It is the life of all hearing these words. It is the life of everyone, everywhere, for all are made in its image and likeness. I remember this truth. I accept my innate wholeness in mind, body, and spirit. And I open to all possibilities for health, joy, and success. I accept Spirit's daily guidance in all my activities. My pursuits are fruitful as I open to God's wisdom and clarity about what is mine to do and mine to be. My relationships are meaningful and joyful as I embrace the perfect child of God that stands before me in the mirror and those I meet throughout my day. My challenges lift me to greater opportunities to experience the wholeness of faith in the law of good that governs all aspects of my life. Compassion and kindness guard my thoughts and my words as I am blessed and a blessing to all. With a joyful and uplifted heart, I embrace the limitless good of God, and I trust that all unfolds now for the greatest and highest good for all. I am grateful for the manifestation of Spirit's gifts of wholeness in me and in everyone. I declare this to be so, and so it is. Today's speaker is our founder and spiritual director, Reverend Karen Wolfson. Her message is entitled, True Freedom, Being Whole. The first is my pleasure to introduce our musical director, Bob Teesdale, who is joined today by guest soloist, Kassie Coykendall. Kassie comes to us from the Big Love Band at the Center for Spiritual Living in Cape Coral, Florida. Kassie says she had been singing from an early age when her father introduced her to karaoke and have her singing along to his guitar playing. That led to performances with school choirs and talent shows, and she has been lifting her voice in song ever since. So please enjoy Kassie and Bob's beautiful rendition of a Beatles classic, Let It Be. Welcome, Kassie and Bob.
In times of trouble, Spirit gently comes to me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be. And in my half darkness, standing right in front of me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be. Let it be, let it be. Let it be. And when the broken-hearted people living in the world agree, there will be an answer. Let it be. For though they may be parted, there is still a chance they will see. There will be an answer. Let it be. Let it be, let it be, let it be, oh let it be. There will be an answer, let it be. Let it be, let it be, let it be, oh let it be. There will be an answer, let it be. Let it be. And when the night cloudy, there is still a light that shines on me. Shine until tomorrow, let it be. I wake up to the sound of music. Spirit gently comes to me, speaking words of wisdom. Let it be. Let it be. Let it be. Let it be. Oh, let it be. Speaking words of wisdom. Let it be. Let it be. Let it be. Let it be. Oh, let it be. There will be an answer. Let it be. Let it be. Let it be. Let it be. Oh, let it be. Whisper words of wisdom. Let it be.
Oh, thank you, Kassie. Thank you. Three simple words, so wise, so comforting, so true. When I find myself in times of trouble, in my hour of darkness, let it be. There will be an answer. Let it be. Don't you love that? You know, that so perfectly fits with what I'm going to share with you today, wrapping up our July series about true freedom. Today, about being whole, and you'll see how it all ties together. But first, let's check in. How's your week been? How's your July been? I'm so happy knowing you're out there, and you know, in the days between these weekly times together, you are in my thoughts, and I'm wondering how you are. How are you getting along? What's going on in your life? If you're watching us on Facebook Live, of course, you know we enjoy your letting us know where you are and the comments that you leave. And to you, our team of financial contributors, you continue to be an absolutely essential part of all that makes it possible for us to share our message, our caring, and our connection. So thank you for standing by us. And of course, thank you all for joining with us today. As I think of you, I continue to affirm and see you as vibrantly healthy and abundantly supported in every way as you express your wholeness. So July's theme, True Freedom, as I've been saying each Sunday this month, was inspired by this month's celebration of our nation's Declaration of Independence and Freedom. It echoes the beautiful ideas of freedom at the very core of New Thought, a philosophy which is all about God, by whatever name, that lovingly created you and me with an irresistible impulse for free expression. Now, Ernest Holmes, the architect of our teaching, wrote, "The divine plan is one of freedom." It's one of the very first things that Holmes wrote. The divine plan is one of freedom. So today's title is True Freedom, Being Whole. In one of his books, Holmes' books, This Thing Called Life, he wrote, "There is a universal wholeness seeking to be revealed through everything and everyone. Some call it God," and he said, "I'm calling it simply life. And this inner wholeness, life, is infinite energy coupled with limitless creative imagination." Wow. Think about that. Life, wholeness, infinite energy, limitless creative imagination. Sounds to me like true freedom. But as you compare this with your day-to-day living, you might have a few questions. I've had a few questions too, especially when I first heard all about this many, many years ago. I'm going to look at four questions that you might have today. First one is, how can I integrate realizing my wholeness with the pursuit of my desires? And let's face it, we all have desires. Well, Ernest Holmes said it pretty directly. He said, "We often think what we require is money, friends, and more, but we are seeking fragments when the whole is at hand. Your inner template of wholeness, think of it like this, as a huge jigsaw puzzle with thousands of pieces, you know, the kind that makes me run from the room in a total lather. All those disconnected pieces lying scattered on a table, just overwhelming. And life can seem like that, a giant, overwhelming jigsaw puzzle. However, remember, every jigsaw puzzle started out as a completed picture. And while reassembling those pieces into that complete picture can be a huge and seemingly impossible task, every piece that's required is sitting right there in front of us. Eric Butterworth, the brilliant Unity minister and author, wrote this. He said, "Behind true desire is the urge not to have, but to be." And then he continues on to say, "We are whole creatures in potential, and the true purpose of desire is to unfold that wholeness to become what we can be." See how he mentions wholeness, to unfold that wholeness. That's what's behind our desire. So take a minute to feel the freedom in that. And here's what I mean. Compare the feeling of constantly pursuing what you desire. When I get it, if I get it, how will I get it? Compare that feeling with the feeling of just being. Now, is there something or someone you fervently want? Well, ask yourself, what is my deeper desire? Who do I think I will be when I get that thing, that person, that situation that I think I want? That's what's stirring in you to be revealed. Not to be acquired, but to be revealed. Dr. Tom Johnson, one of my dear friends and a longtime minister of religious science, wrote this. He said, "Our need may seem to be for something, some person, but we must realize that this need is really a demand of the infinite energy and creativity within us to be used, to be revealed. Our need is not a need to acquire, but a need to reveal the wholeness within." And he goes on to say, when we are living out of a sense of wholeness, we never see a need as being something or someone, but rather as an urge to reveal something. And he says, there's nothing wrong with having things and people in our life, but they can only be there in a creative way when they represent what we ourselves are revealing. Wow, that's a whole 180 shift, isn't it? So now the second question. What about distressing and even worse events like rejection and disappointment, those times when I feel really broken? Where does this wholeness and this true freedom tie in? Well, here again are the words of Dr. Tom Johnson. Each time we have a challenge, the power is not in what we can get, but what we can reveal. So he says, ask, what is God seeking to reveal by means of me in this challenge? And get this. He says, every time we feel tension in our body, it's because we've put our attention outside, thinking the power is there rather than within. So he gives us this suggestion. In the wake of rejection, disappointment, all of these things that can sideline us, say, there is a divine purpose within my being that God is now revealing. I am ready for this next forward step, and I'm ready for greater service to the world. I love that because not only is it talking about revealing our inner wholeness, even when we're looking at a daunting situation, pain and problems and challenges, but it's talking about this leading us into being of greater service to the world. It's not just being self-absorbed. It benefits the world. Number three question. Does wholeness preclude change? Not at all. It's kind of paradoxical. Ernest Holmes reminds us, our individual universe is forever complete, yet forever completing itself, in order that every experience may teach us to transcend some previous one in ever-ascending cycles upward bound. What he's saying is, just because you're whole doesn't mean you're finished. Just because you're whole doesn't mean you're finished. But change is an inevitable byproduct of allowing our wholeness to be revealed. Rachel Naomi Remen, a renowned MD, writes eloquently, "Change is less about fixing and more about uncovering hidden wholeness in all events and all people, and remembering our inner power to make a difference." And she goes on to say, "This has greatly changed the way that I am as a physician and also as a teacher. It has given me new eyes, looking for the wholeness instead of trying to fix." Everyone and everything in it, she says, has in it a seed of greater wholeness, a dream of possibility. So what we once saw as broken or lacking might just as easily be seen as the growing edge of things, a place to be valued and nurtured in ourselves. It's a lot to think about. Our growing edge of revealing our wholeness. And then the fourth question, the final one, might be, how do I do this? How can I reveal my innate wholeness? Well, here's a hint. Reverend Terry Hershey quotes Rabbi Levine. And Rabbi Levine said this, "I haven't found the answers yet, but I think I'm asking the right questions." Asking the right questions. Those might be questions like, instead of asking what is wrong, ask what is whole, what is well. Not pretending that brokenness isn't there, but that I am more than my brokenness. Underneath the pain and the problems is my divine wholeness, infinite energy, remember, as I said earlier, and creativity. And this brings me to where we started this conversation today. Paul McCartney's three simple words, let it be, let it be. So wise, so comforting, so true. I'm telling you, when we can let it be, our inner wholeness, we kind of get out of the way of our inner wholeness being revealed. Remember the song said, when I find myself in times of trouble and in my hour of darkness, let it be. There will be an answer. Let it be. You know, I receive these daily emails from a writer named Jeff Kober. And this one, this week, caught my attention. He wrote, "After 30 years of trying, I finally stopped trying to fix myself. Oh yes, some of my strategies and practices and tools helped for a while, but my struggle persisted." And he quotes Peter Russell, who wrote a lot of books, but one of them was From Science to God. Interesting book, too. But he quotes him, Peter Russell saying, "When we stop doing all the things that obscure the peace, and I'm going to add the wholeness that is there at our very core, we find that what we have been seeking all along is there waiting silently for us. Let it be." And Kober continues about his struggle. He says, "After endless struggle, when I finally, from sheer weariness, surrendered, I discovered who I was." In other words, he let it be, and he discovered who he was, wholeness. So rather than desperately trying to become something or someone else, and in this, as he said, "In this surrender, I allowed myself to be led by something other than my ego, and the seemingly miraculous happened." Freedom. Reminded me of my own experience, one of many along these lines, but one way back when I was just starting out in my 12-step recovery program, I don't remember, did I say it was 40 years ago or so? And I was so weary of trying to keep things in, keep control of everything and to do my very best. And that had always been my MO. And I was just tired. But I really didn't know what else to do. I figured the opposite of trying to be in control and keeping on striving to fix myself, the opposite would be, I don't know, destruction, failure, the end of the road. But then it hit me one day in one of my 12-step meetings, and I thought, what's so bad about just being average, being mediocre? Just what's so bad about that? In other words, giving up that struggle. Let go, let it be. And you know, amazingly, it took a while, but my life expanded in wonderful ways I could never have imagined. What a relief when I learned I didn't need to be fixed, but that I could let it be and know that my growing pains were simply evidence of my, as Rachel Naomi Remen said, my growing edge, my innate wholeness being revealed. So take all of this and be who you are, as the Creator made you. And that opens the way for your wholeness truly to be revealed. What an exciting journey you'll find that it is. I'm going to close with this by Archbishop Desmond Tutu, who said, "A life of wholeness does not depend on what we experience. It depends on how we experience our lives." So now, in closing, Kassie is going to invite us to that courageous experience with a great song by Claudia Caruana, Fearless. Now that is true freedom. We'll see you soon.
I was born to live life fully, to let go of regret, to walk the higher wire of life without a safety net, to follow something even bigger than my pride, to show up with courage even when I'm trembling inside. I will not worry about what others think of me, and I will not be shackled by the chains of conformity. I'll break the mold set in the past, keep pushing till I'm free at last. Of life, I throw my heart right over the bar. On the other side of fear, there's euphoria and a better understanding of who you really are. I'll break the mold set in until I'm free at last. I follow the path of my heart and make my life a work of art. I'll be fearless. I
Thanks, Kassie and Bob, for gifting us with your inspiring musical message. Reverend Karen, what a wonderful reminder of our innate wholeness and our freedom to live from that truth. The Center for Spiritual Living Sarasota is pleased to support you with prayer, inspiration, encouragement, and opportunities for virtual community and connection. And now is the time to share our offering that supports our ability to continue to be here for you. There are three easy ways to contribute. On your screen, you'll see our website where you can select the donate button, which allows you to contribute via PayPal or credit card, or mail a check to our address shown here on our website, or you can arrange automatic contributions through your own online banking. Now I invite you to take your virtual gift in your hand, place it over your heart, blessing it as you share it, and know this with me: my gift goes forth to heal, to bless, and to prosper, and the divine flow returns it to me multiplied abundantly. And now let us declare together our offering affirmation. The words are on your screen. I give thanks that I may share of my good, my love, and my support. Thank you so much. I have a few announcements to share today. Do you have a prayer request? Here on our website, www.cslsarasota.com, you will find the green prayer request button, where you may seek prayer support for any intention you may have. We have four licensed spiritual practitioners: Ron Frost, Jim Grove, Nicole Leeds, and me, who are available to know and affirm spiritual truth with and for you. These practitioners are also available by appointment for one-hour spiritual coaching sessions. These sessions offer the opportunity to explore a deeper understanding and practical application of the spiritual truth in the midst of your problem or challenging issue. For more information, check out their page at our website by selecting the Staff tab on the left. Here on our website, you can also sign up to receive our weekly email newsletter or check out our Facebook page for posts about upcoming events. Our Spiritual Living Circle continues on Zoom every Wednesday from 7 to 8 p.m. Licensed spiritual practitioner Jim Grove leads a thought-provoking discussion on an article from this month's Science of Mind magazine. The topic this week is Who Am I? A Journey of Self-Discovery by Margaret Stortz. To participate, email Jim and he will send you all the details, including the discussion guide and a copy of the article. Newcomers are always welcome, so check it out this week. And now, as we conclude this sacred time together, let us do so with the intention to live in health, love, joy, and perfect peace. I invite you to listen or join in singing our closing song, Let There Be Peace on Earth. Thank you so much for being with us.
Take, let this be my solemn life.